hickory dickory dock. Ooh, it's time to beat the clock. Time for fun has now begun. Let's all play beat the clock.
Beat the Clock is brought to you by Sylvania. For half a century, a quality name in incandescent bulbs, fluorescent tubes and fixtures, photo lamps, radio and television sets, radio and television tubes and electronic devices. Yes, for homes, offices, schools and factories, Sylvania.
Let's all play Beat the Clock.
And now, here is America's number one clock watcher, Bud Collyer!
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, and welcome once again to Beat the Clock, the show where you can have the time of your life playing against time for big-time prizes. Right now, let's get around to the pleasant business of re-meeting some people we just barely met last week. How are you?
Nice to see you again. You sound more scared than you did last week.
How are you?
How do you do, sir?
Mr. and Mrs. Herman Hoffman of South Ozone Park, Long Island, New York. Let's give them a warm welcome, too. We're glad they're here. I see by your card, Herman, that you're a dictaphone serviceman. Is that right?
Sir.
That mean you have to go around whenever the dictaphone talks back to the dictator and service it up. Is that it?
That's right, sir.
And how long have you been with this company?
Over 5 years.
You're married 6 months.
That's right.
Boy, still on your honeymoon then, aren't you, huh?
Yeah.
Always will be.
Attaboy. You come up with the right answer, and real fast. Incidentally, Mrs. Hoffman, you'll be interested to know that the bonus stunt is worth tonight $1,200. $1,200, and you may be the one that gets to try it. Anybody, any lady that's up here at the time, when that bell rings, that's a signal to me that that is the one that gets to try at the bonus. It's the one with the two cups. You know the one it is. Oh, and incidentally, for the two of you, we have here, this is a pattern right here of one of the those wonderful little aprons that Roxanne wears. You've seen this? And from Sylvania. Also for you, sir, is a little football booklet.
Thank you.
The scores, the names of the players, and things like that. You know, you can't tell the players without a Sylvania guy. That sort of a thing. We have them for every lady and gentleman on our show, as a matter of fact. All right, let's get to the problem at hand, which happened to be a stunt that you never even got to last week when time ran out. On the $100 clock, let's see what your problem is going to be. If you will come over here with me, sir, alone, Mrs. Hoffman can stand by there and just kind of watch you go to work. Now, here, Herman, is stand right back here, if you will, please, sir. We put rubbers on your feet purposely to give you something to grip with, you see? Because here we have placed a tennis ball, which we have marked with black stripes so you can see it a little better when it's up in the air. We've marked a square on the stage. What you have to do, sir, is to bounce that as hard as you want to on that little square. It must always be bounced on that square. While the ball is up in the air, get over here, grab this cup, come back here, and catch the ball in the cup. Just once. Just catch it once. That's all you have to do. And take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. You have 55 seconds. Now, Herman, if you don't make it, just drop the cup anywhere and don't worry about it because the cups will be replaced each time. And also, Betty is standing over there with a fresh supply of balls. Run over there and grab another one if you can't retrieve the ball easily. Don't waste any time, in other words, see? Make the whole thing that you do trying to get the cup in the ball in the cup. Okay, 55 seconds. Are you lefty?
No, I'm righty.
Well, then you better stand up here because, you know, you bounce it here and you get right down there. That means this side of you is nearer to the cup. Otherwise, you'd be away from it. All right, are you ready? In the square. Go. Here you are, boy. Almost. Drop the cup. Get a pressure. Pick up the ball. Keep trying. Just drop the cup. And a ball! Seems, you know, you start to grow when I should. It's not as impossible. When you try it, you realize these things can all be done. We try them on ourselves first. We can't do them. I mean, we can do them. So, you did that much, much better time, as a matter of fact, than those of us who tried it this afternoon. You did a real good job on that. Let's see now, Mr. and Mrs. Hoffman, South Ozone Park. I hope we're all watching, keeping their fingers.
Oh, man.
Back to the $200 clock for Mr. and Mrs. Herman Hoffman. And, Herman, hey, what we did to you, huh? We got you all fixed up there. Well, that's fine, because your next little item has to do with the $200 clock, and to do... Opponent! You get the ball! Come on, Miss Hoffman. Let's go out with those two little spatulas. Ooh, a nice spatula. Now, if you'll take that in your left hand, you take this in your right hand. Have you seen the stud?
Yes,
you've
I
seen
have.
Them try. You know how it must end up, then. It must end up with this one on this one, and it must end up with this cup on this. And you may not use either one to help the other, nor press it against your body, of course, in any way. This is worth $1,200 tonight. I'll hang that there without swinging around. We'll stop that one nice and easy for you. Meantime, you take a look over my shoulder and yours and see how many seconds you've got. 50 seconds. Are you ready? Go. You didn't beat the clock beat you, but a good try, believe me. You get out there, you know, you're a lot more nervous than you are if you're trying it at home, I'll tell you. Were you? Oh, dear, that is correct. Is that the same size cup and everything?
Yeah.
A little smaller. Well, that may have been the difference, you see. If you're practicing at home, I don't know what size cups these are, but they're the large molded milk container size cups, in case any of you folks want to try it and sort of develop the technique there, because it would make a difference, you know, in the way they'd sit on those. But anyway, good try. And you haven't lost anything by it. All you got to do is move on out of the $200 clock, and that's coming up right now. If you both come over here with me, I'll show you what's in store for you. Now, let's bring out our little shooting range there. There we are. What did you say, Miss Hoffman?
Wonderful.
Wonderful. I figured you'd say that. All right. Step right in there, if you will, please, Herman. And the girls have a shower cap for you. I want you to put it right on your head. Now, stand right up on that stool. Normally, people sit down on it, but not on Beat the Clock. You step right up on the stool, if you will. Stand right up on it. And the girls are going to give you a large metal wastebasket. I want you to hold it to yourself, see? Just hold it. Hold it right against your chest. That's the idea. A little lower than that, I think. If I was that, much better, I think. Now, all you have to do is to catch any one of these paper cups in that wastebasket without getting off the stool. Now, the way you do it is your wife is going to propel them over to you using these bottles of seltzer. There we are. I'm very sorry that we can't decorate you as we normally would, but because of the milk strike in New York, we felt that even if we could get cream or milk to whip, it wouldn't be so good to waste it that way. So here we are. You get set and take a look at our clock. See how many seconds you have. You have 40 seconds from the time I say go. Catch two cups in that paper can. Are you ready? Go! Go! Hold it, hold it, hold it. Stop the clock. We need a fresh container. We got one right here, boy. There you go. All right, are you ready? Go! Stop the clock. We got plenty of cups here. Set them up there. That's it. You care to go right ahead while the battle's doing that? Huh? All right, you ready? Go! Seltzer? No more? All right, we'll give it to you then. Fair enough. Sure shot Sylvania bombs. That's the idea. And you come on back over here with me. Whenever we run out of any of the wherewithals, why, that's our fault, not yours. You certainly didn't run out of aim or patience. In fact, I think you were enjoying yourself, weren't you? All right, this is, he doesn't take it out of you when he gets it home. Now, if you step up here on our little platform here and turn around and face the audience, Miss Hoffman, now comes your turn to try our famous jackpot board. On that board are all the words of a famous saying or quotation, but they're all mixed up and out of order. You have 20 seconds to get them back in order so that we can read the saying or quotation. Got it? Okay, don't look till I tell you to now. Open the curtain. Turn around, take a look. Go! Stop the clock while the cat's away, the mice will play. You're right! Well, our congratulations to you, Mrs. Hoffman. Having beaten the jackpot clock, let's see see what you've won. Just take a look over here.
It's the 1954 Sylvania Stratford with a 21-inch screen and the great new photo power chassis for photographically clear pictures in even the most distant reception areas. And, of course, the Stratford has halo light for the greatest eye comfort in all television. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Hoffman. You have just won Sylvania's jackpot prize.
And whom do we have now?
Thought I'd like you to meet Mr. and Mrs. Marvin Mayer from Summit, New Jersey.
Thank you very much. Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Mayer. How are you? Hello. Nice to have you here. Ms. Mayer, how are you?
Fine, thank you.
Step right in a little closer, because these microphones are set here to pick up your voices and want your friends and neighbors to hear you. Nice. I hope they're all watching over there in Summit. You suppose they are?
Certainly are.
You have family, Marvin?
No, we have no children. Mm-hmm. We're married 8.5 months.
I see. Well, I don't want to rush you. Don't misunderstand me. I didn't know, though. I mean, that shouldn't have made any problem for you. Married 8.5 months, I noticed that your job is production expediter.
That's right.
Yes. Well, and my question was all right, wasn't it? All right, Marvin, I hope you're having a good time visiting us. We always like to meet friends and neighbors who are watching our show week after week. As a matter of fact, do you do most of the housework around the house?
Yes, I do.
You do. Well, we have something ought to fit right in, and it's for you on the $100 clock. Come over here with me, Ms. Mayer, if you will.
Leave my bag.
Oh, sure, leave it right there. That's it. Okay, step right over here, and I ask you to turn and face the audience, and Betty has a blindfold for you. We will slip on, and you tell us when you can't see a single thing. All right?
Fine.
That's it. All right, fine. Okay, now we're going to bring an item out that is a common part of every housewife's daily work, as a rule, or at least a couple of days each week. And it happens to be one of those collapsible ironing boards, you know, a folding ironing board. Now, it's in front of you now, but don't reach out and touch it yet. The girls are going to take that ironing board and collapse it on the floor right in front of you. I'll show you where it is in just a minute. Then, all you have to do is to stand that ironing board up again so that it's standing all by itself. You understand the problem?
Yes,
you know,
I
just
do.
Unfold the legs so that it's in. Now, in order to keep you from pinching your little fingers, we're going to put boxing gloves on your hands.
Oh, no.
Yes, we are. We're going to put them on backwards so that it makes it a little harder for you to feel the shake.
Oh, no.
And slide right in there. That's the idea. Now, I'll take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. You have exactly 50 seconds to get it standing up all by itself. Now, just come forward just a little bit. If you bend forward now on the floor, the ironing board is directly in front of you, just about 8 inches. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Go.
Good girl!
It just goes to prove the old adage. How many times have you said, I could set this thing up blindfolded, haven't you?
Yes, I have.
Or in my sleep. Well, we didn't put you to sleep, but we took away your sense of feel by putting those boxing gloves on backwards, took away your sight by covering up your eyes, and you still did it just like that. I would advise you to try it at home, though. You might find it a lot different.
I didn't know what to do.
Well, we have to move you along now to the very next clock, which is the $200 clock, Mr. and Ms. Mayer. If you'll both come over here with me, let's see how well you've learned to cooperate with each other in your 8.5 months of married life. You'll step over there and take one of those pool cues, Ms. Mayer. I'm going to give the other one to your husband. First, I'm going to tell you what it is you have to do. Here we have tipped each one of these pool cues with some sponge rubber for a very definite reason. You'll notice that along the floor here under this board are a series of dishes. Now, using only the ends of these pool cues, you ought to take a dish and slide it up here and get it into that square. Hold it there while your wife gets one up and brings it up and stacks it on top of that one. They don't care which one holds the two while the other one goes down and gets a third one up and stacks it with the other two. They must be stacked so that no pool cue is in between any. I don't care how many pool cues are holding it from the top or underneath, but all three dishes must be stacked together. Got the idea?
Yes.
Take a look at the clock, and I'll tell you how many seconds you have. 55 seconds from the time I say go. Do you understand your problem?
Yes.
Are you ready? You can use both hands. Go! You take one. Hurry up. That's the idea. You better start yours up there quick. Don't waste any time. That's it. Oh, all right, got two.
you didn't beat the clock. The clock beat you, but a good try it was. Believe me, you did a fine job trying for it. Come on back over, Mr. Mayor. Badly about because you have beaten our $100 clock, so let's see what you've won.
A charming early American period wing love seat of highest quality workmanship. This beautiful addition to your furniture group is custom built and intricately tailored by the Shaw Manufacturing Company. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Mayor. You have just won a Beat the Clock prize worth more than $100.
Now.
Bud, now I'd like you to meet Sharon and her mother and father, Master Sergeant and Mrs. John Kramer from Merrick, New York.
Well, thank you very much. Welcome to you and a welcome from our audience, too, for this fine family. What is your name, Link? You're Sharon, are you? Huh? What do we do, pop your belt buckle there? Just when we said Sharon, it popped open. And maybe it's trained to do that. How old are you, Sharon? You know what it says on the card here? It says, Roxanne doll with a question mark. Now, I don't know, some girls continue to collect dolls even long after they stop playing with them. How about you?
Well, I just set them on my bed.
You set them on your bed so you'd like one, would you? Roxanne, bring out a Roxanne doll, will you? Got one handy there? There it is.
Here.
Show her how it walks. Go ahead. She hasn't. Oh. We haven't shown how this walks in quite a while. Look at there. See her little head turn when she walks? Isn't she cute? Well, that's all for you. You set her in your room there. I hope it'll remind you of the pleasant visit you had to our show. Sergeant, how long have you been in the Marines?
26 years.
26 years. Do you plan to make a career of it?
I believe so.
Decided you like it by now. How long married, Miss Kramer?
16 years.
Is this your only child?
The only
Awful
one.
Good sample you got there, isn't it, huh?
It's a good girl.
I should say. Well, let's get along and see what we have in store for you folks on the $100 clock. Ever play ping pong?
I have.
How about you, Miss Kramer?
Yes, I have.
Sure. Well, we have a new kind of ping pong for you. Now, I don't think your daughter's ever seen one like this, but you two come over here with me, if you will, please. Miss Kramer, if you will have it, see, I'll show you before you sit down. Here we have a post on top of which is a box. Now, if you will sit down on this side of the post, facing out this way, not too far, right? Just sit right down. Sit right down on the floor. That's the idea. And, Sergeant, if you'll sit down on this side, back to back with your wife, don't lean against the post, just a little ways away. That's it. Get comfortable. Now, we have here a couple of ping pong paddles. There's one for you and one for the sergeant. And here we have rather large ping pong balls. Now, we'll give these to you as soon as the one that you're after gets out of range. Don't go chasing too far after it. Keep after it as long as you can, but we'll keep refeeding new ones to you. All you have to do is get two of those up in this box, and we'll stop the clock, and you'll beat the clock. Now, you can get them both in, or, Sergeant, you can get them both in, or you can each get one. I don't care who gets them in as long as two land in that box. Do you understand? Okay, you can only use the ping pong paddle, and you can't turn around. You must remain with your back to it all the time. Take a look at the clock. See how many seconds you have. 55 seconds. Are you ready? Go. Up there and try to get it right over the top of the box. Reach way out. That's better. Reach right out with your hand. Want to sit a little further away from the post? Sit a little further away if you want. Is it going to help you any? Sit a little further away from the post. Get out a little bit. You can hit back further. That's a girl. The clock beat you, but a good try, and we have something for you. Some little. Here we are, Sergeant and Mrs. There you have one of our Sylvania table model radios. Use it in good health. Thank you very much for being our guest tonight. I'm sorry that you didn't beat the clock. Good night, honey. It was certainly nice having you with us tonight. Roxanne, who are our next contestants?
Right here. But now we have Mr. and Mrs.
Steady, steady, steady. Easy does it. One of our gals is a little balloon shy. That's all the trouble is there. And I think also that you find you can remove those balloons without breaking them, and in the future I think we will do so, huh? All right, Roxanne, who do we have?
Mr. and Mrs. Jack Mellon from Rego Park, Long Island, New York.
Thank you very much, Roxanne. Okay. Very nice to have you here, Miss Mellon. How are you? Jack, how are you, sir? Pleasure to meet you. Now, let's see. What do you do, Jack?
I teach magic to children.
You teach magic to children? Boy, would my son love you.
I think they would.
Oh, he's having a lot of fun with it. He has his own magic.
Boys don't like ballet. And
no,
magic,
that's true.
Magic to me and teaching it to children is like ballet.
Well, it is in a way.
It's coordination. It's a synchronization of the entire body, limbs, mm-hmm. and speaking, everything.
And, of course, it's a lot of fun, too, the illusion they create. Well, I tell you what, we're going to get along to your first stunt. Just...
I'm Matthew Lesko and my...
I see by your card you have a son, 4 years old.
Yes.
What's his name?
David.
And you have a girl, 5 and a half?
And she's Lisa. May I say hello to them?
Well, of course you may. Wave right into that camera.
Hello, Lisa. Hello, David.
Boy, they look just fine, don't they, huh? I'll tell you what.
Go to sleep.
What did you say?
Go to sleep after the show.
Yeah, go to sleep after the show.
And listen to Grandma, okay?
Grandma's there,
yes,
too?
Yes, she's taking care of them.
How nice. I'll tell you what. We have something for them. For that boy of yours, going to give you one of these Sylvania trucks that he can have backstage. And, of course, for the young lady, she will get a Roxanne doll.
Thank you so
Take,
much.
You're very welcome. Take it along with you. Now, Mr. and Miss Mallon, let's see what your problem is on the $100 clock. I think, if you don't mind, can you operate all right without your glasses, sir? Tuck them in your pocket or right down there. It'll be fine. If you both come over here with me, I'll show you what your problem is. Now, have here a little necklace for you. I'm going to put it on your black dress there so we can see it easier. And have here a little necklace for you. These are just ropes that we've made two different colors, as you see. Now, what I want you to do is this. I want you to exchange these little rope necklaces so that you have the black one and you have the white one. Do you understand? And to do it, I want you to stand back to back, if you will, and hold hands. That's it. Now, you must hold hands throughout this entire proposition. This should be a cinch for you if you teach magic. All you have to do is, without using your hands to help, just get this off and over, and just use your heads, you know, put your two heads together and get one over onto the other so that you've exchanged at the end of it. You look a little nonplussed. Something wrong?
I'm supposed to get the white one, the black one on her, and that's she's supposed right. to get hers on mine?
Sure, that's it.
I have no idea how to do
Well, I'll give you one little hint. Look, instead of staying back to back, I didn't say you had to. You must remain holding hands.
Oh.
Hold hands back there. But you can turn quite a ways this way, even if you still hold hands. You get the idea?
Well,
can't touch it with your hands. Now, take a look at the clock. See how many seconds you have. 55 seconds. I tell you, you find this wonderful coordination in magic. Are you ready? Go!
I just put my gun.
Not with your hands. No, use your head. Not with your hands. Using your hands. No. I have to stop it. I'm sorry, because you cannot use your hands to push it. Now, let me show you what I mean by this. Look, take a look. Suppose your wife has this one on here. See? It's possible for you to get your head down and through there and then pull it off her head. You see? And then you can do the same thing with this. Get the idea? All right. Are you ready? Go. What a stunt for a teacher of magic.
He couldn't do it.
That's one you thought you couldn't do, wasn't it, huh? What'd he do, almost wring your hand off?
Yeah.
He was trying to... Well, in any event, it got you through, Howard. It got you through the first stunt. Let's see what it is on the $200 clock. Will you both come over here with me, please? No, you won't need it for this. This'll be fine. Now, if you will stand on either side of me here, thank you very much, Madeline. Here are two little stuffed gloves that we put on the ends of two sticks here, you see? One is for you, and you must hold it with two hands or one if you wish, but always by the little tape handle down here. You see, we've marked out an area. You can't go beyond that. Now, here are three milk cartons. Now, all I want you to do is to stack these milk cartons up so that they are stacked up like that, using only those sticks with the two gloves on the ends. You understand the problem? Take a look at the clock. See how many seconds you have. You have 55 seconds. Are you ready? Go! We'll get it. You go ahead with the... You still have 35 seconds left. Can you come back next week?
Yes.
All right, you'll be our first contestants then. Go home and practice your magic, boy. Right now, this is Bud Collyer speaking for Sylvania, hoping that next time may be your time to beat the clock. Good night, everybody. Thank you.
production. Produced in association with the CBS Television Network. Roxanne's Gone by Larry Over. Beat the Clock is brought to you by Sylvania. Mrs. Byrne Bennett reminding you to tune in every week at the same time for Beat the Clock.